All right, folks, I'm Captain Rennie Clark here with my buddy Will Lear, and we are going to do a product review tonight. Last week, we did a product review of Toughline, and we had almost 50 people share it up till this point.
Absolutely.
And tonight's the big night.
Tonight's the big night. We're going to pick a winner on that prize package. We'll throw a picture up of the prize package in a little while, too, at some point, and let everybody know we did show it on the last YouTube video, though, and it's got some Toughline in there. It's got some Category 5, I forget which one. Was it Suicide Croaker?
Suicide Croaker Tiger Baits,
which is one of the things that we're going to be talking about tonight. It's a good little prize package out there, Marine Warehouse Center, throwing in some stuff as well. We always appreciate those guys. And, we got some good stuff. Lucky winner will go home with that.
Yeah, you guys are going to get some cool swag. And, of course, the Toughline 20-pound test, four-carrier braid, the Force. I had Bo, the rep for Toughline, on my boat yesterday, and we were using the different kinds of Toughline and caught everything from catfish to redfish.
Absolutely.
And, man, I can't say enough about that line. But getting into this show, Will, the suspense is killing me, man. We got to pick a number. And how we're going to do this, my wife did a list of everybody that shared the post, the podcast, just like the rules were. You had to share the podcast to get into the giveaway. That's all you had to do. In the future, we're going to have you like our page and share it. So because a couple of the people we weren't able to find on there that shared it. But almost everybody is represented, and we are going to pick a number. Will's going to pick a number, and I'm going to pick a number. And then we're going to take the number that's in the middle of those two numbers. That'll be the fairest way to do it.
And before we do that, we just want to say thanks again to everybody out there that has taken the time to share that post. We had a really good week, a lot of downloads on the podcast, and really one of the big reasons we had so many downloads is because of you guys out there sharing that link. And really just exposing the podcast to a whole lot more people than we're able to do by ourselves. So thank you guys out there again. We really appreciate it. And yeah, I'm looking forward to giving this thing away. And we're going to be, I'm really looking forward to continuing to give stuff away as we get bigger and bigger. So this is going to be cool. There's going to be a lot of stuff in the future coming out that you guys are going to want to take advantage of as well.
Yeah. Every month right now, we're giving away stuff that I'm sponsored personally by for tournaments. In the future, we are going to have some of those same sponsors that sponsor this show. And, you know, we're bringing in new sponsors, too. If you're wanting to get in on, you know, sponsoring this show, and you have a product out there that is not represented, or a segment that's not represented as far as leader line or topwater baits or, you know, rods, reels. I mean, we do have reel sponsors, Synetic Reels, for the show. So
yeah, absolutely. There's just so much stuff out there.
Yeah.
I mean, it's hard for us to cover all the bases. But if you guys out there are personally involved with a good company and you stand behind the product, you know, we'd like to test it out and put it to the test. And, you know, if it's a good product, like I'm sure it is, if you're standing behind it, then, you know, we'll feature it on here. And then, you know, maybe down the road, if you're looking for some sponsorship opportunities, then we'd love to talk about that.
Let me throw a hint in. We need some fishing apparel, fishing shirts, shoes. That's one thing we have no representation right now. We do have Synetic Lifestyle, you know, which has shirts and that sort of thing and buffs. But we need, you know, some different kind of apparel as well. You know, pants, fishing pants, shoes. So without further ado, enough about that. Let's go ahead and pick a winner, man. It's killing me. What's your number?
I'm going with
one,
eight.
Eight? I'm going to go with 22.
8 and 22.
So 22 minus 8.
Now we got to do some math on the spot. We should have thought about this. We should have thought this through a little bit better.
All right, let's see.
Man, we need some Jeopardy music playing in the background
or
something.
We absolutely do.
I remember that for next time. I won't have that. Maybe next time we'll come up with two numbers that We can calculate a little bit quicker. How about that?
That's right. I'm just pulling the list up right now. So, yeah, a little bit of, come on, Will. You're the sound guy, man. You're the expert in this, man. You got to come up with something. Jeopardy music next time?
Jeopardy music next time?
Yeah.
It might be. Unless we can come up with some like John Wayne style showdown kind of music. How about that?
Hey, whatever you come up with,
some
I'm
Wild
sure it'll
West,
sound good.
Some gunshots. We'll figure up something for next time.
All right, obviously 22 minus 8 is 14. So what is this? Seven numbers on either side of it, right?
Yeah.
So 15, the number 15, is that correct?
15.
All right. Y'all don't send me if my math's wrong. That's what we're going with.
15. It's random anyway, so we're going to go with 15.
We don't know who's on the list. I'm just pulling it up right now. 15. Oh, boy. My buddy, good friend Brad Wood.
All right.
He's been on my boat several times. Has been with us from the start of the podcast, shared it. I mean, he shared it the first day we had it up.
Well, great. I'm glad that he's getting it for the first time then. We appreciate it out there, Brad, for everything that you've done so far. And, man.
Brad's a great fisherman, does a lot of fishing all over the country, lives in the Jacksonville, North Carolina area. Mm-hmm. Very avid red fisherman, puts in a lot of time around Swansburg, North Carolina, and New River. So, Brad, you're the lucky winner, and I will be contacting you. You are going to be so easy for me to get an address to send the prize back to because, you know, I know how to get a hold of you. So, congratulations.
Well, this is what we need. We need you to go out there and use this stuff. Use the Category 5 baits and use the tough line. Send us a message. Report back how you like it. I know you're going to like it because it's good stuff. We're supporting it. So, send us a message back. Send us some fish pics or something like that of some stuff you've caught on that. That'd be cool.
Yeah, all this stuff we're giving away right now is stuff I use every day on charters and tournaments. That otherwise, this product wouldn't be sitting in front of you right now.
Yep.
So, getting past that, Brad, congratulations. I'm going to show everybody else how to rig these baits. Brad, I know you know how to do it. You've used them on my boat, so we're going to get right into it. Category 5 is a soft plastic manufacturer out of Slidell, Louisiana. My friend Richie Boulot is the owner, and Richie has been behind us for years, giving us these bait, providing these baits for us. I've been on pro staff with him for years now. So the first time I was introduced to these baits, I kind of looked at them and I'm like, I don't know about these. You know, it kind of looks like a storm swim shad without a wade and a hook in it, you know.
Right.
And then I think the first baits I ever used, I stopped by in Louisiana and met Richie. Richie said, look, y'all are coming through. I want you to try my baits down here. I've got a bait for everything in the marsh. And obviously everybody that fishes inshore probably has heard, if they haven't been there, how good Louisiana fishing is. It is the best inshore fishing in the country, and it's not even a close second anywhere. Mm-hmm. So if they're good enough for everything that swims or every kind of bait in the marsh, I mean, they make even crawfish type baits, freshwater type baits, even long, big baits for stripers. They've got like one that's like a manic minnow that's, I think, 8 inches. It's a big bait. Oh. So you could use them offshore as well. But let's get right into it. They make a tiger bait, which is probably the most popular inshore bait with anglers all over the country that are using these. You can get these baits at Bass Pro Shops and Cabela's or straight through Category 5 amongst other places. There are a couple shops here in our area that carry them. One is Island Bait and Tackle. Another one just went out of business up in Snead's Ferry or Holly Ridge that Will just went to a couple weeks ago.
Yeah, just scored some up there on the clearance rack because the guy was closing up shop, but that along with a lot of other stuff. But yeah, they had them up there in Holly Ridge, which I wasn't expecting to see those there.
Yeah, Captain David Baxley, a friend of mine from Holly Ridge, he's the one that actually introduced me to these baits years ago. He's the one that put me and Richie in contact, so thanks, David. And he also is the one that originally got those baits in all these stores around here.
Yeah.
So but either way, let's get right into it. This tiger bait, most people are going to use a jig head. And if you listen to the podcast last week, Ashley Louder and I were mistakenly calling the jig heads he used to win the tournament in the Southern Redfish Cup Championship trout eye jig heads, which are made by Z-Man. These are redfish eye, not trout eye, guys. I don't know how many people contacting me this week asking about, you know, were these jig heads the same as Z-Man? These are not. This is a totally different company, and they're made in the Low Country, I believe, by Ralph Phillips Inshore Productions, redfisheye.com. So I wanted to make sure we got that out there.
And not to step on your toes there, I believe what's going on, what the confusion lies with this, I think there's actually three different versions of these. There's a trout eye, a redfish eye, and a striper eye.
Okay.
And I'm pretty sure that, and correct me if I'm wrong out there, Ralph Phillips, I know you got, you actually shared one of our posts last, this week, and I appreciate that, by the way. We really appreciate that support and sent some folks over to our podcast where we were talking about the trout eye. I think that the three are the different weights. The trout eye is the smaller one. The redfish eye is the midweight, and then the striper eye is the larger of the three. I could be wrong on that. We'll double-check that, but I think that's what it is.
Well, I don't know much about the product, except I use the ones that say Redfish Eye on them, which are these packs here. Ashley gave me a handful of them at the captain's meeting at Southern Redfish Cup. Like I said, I'm not sponsored by Redfish Eye or Ralph Phillips Productions, but these are really good jig heads, and I have been using them ever since for everything from near shore to inshore, and I've caught hundreds of fish at this point near shore with these.
Yep.
Jig heads, but
regardless, it's a great product.
Yeah, this little pack right here that Ashley gave me has got a 1/8 ounce jig head in it and a 3/16 ounce jig head, and it looks like there's three different sizes of the redfish eye. If there are different species eyes, I'm not sure. I'll have to check, but either way, we're going to show you how to rig these baits on a jig head. Category 5, like I said, this suicide croaker is a very easy bait to rig with a jig head. It is a little more difficult with a weedless application, but I am going to show you. You can just feed it through the plastic and try to come out in the center up top. So this bait will swim straight. I'll let Will hold it up to the camera. That is one way to rig this bait. And that's how most people are going to rig that bait, is with a jig head. Now, Captain Rennie Clark does not use many jig heads. I'm usually fishing less than a, 2 foot of water, a lot of times less than a foot of water where I'm actually catching the fish. I might be sitting in 2 or 3 foot of water with my boat, but I will be casting in water that's barely covering their backs. If you've seen some of my YouTube videos, I get really skinny. I do a lot of high tide fishing in our area for tailing redfish. Will, you've been out there with me a couple times doing that. That's a different kind of fishing.
Absolutely.
So the hook that you need to rig the suicide croaker, only the suicide croaker, not the shrimp minnow or the manic minnow, is an Owner 4-0 Beast hook. Now, Eagle Claw Trocar, which is owned by Eagle Claw, makes a hook that is identical to this hook. I don't know the sizes, but this is a 4-0 Owner, and that's the smallest size, to my knowledge, they make, or it was for years, or it's the smallest size we can get in our shops here in the Wilmington area. But it rigs this bait perfectly because it's got the wide gap. Without the wide gap, you will not be able to set the hook effectively when a fish strikes, and it also will get bound up on the bottom of this bait where it will not swim correctly. So what you want to do is turn the bait a little bit and go through the middle of the bait and try to come out of the top. It's a very difficult bait to rig like this, but I'll trust me when I tell you, this bait is absolutely deadly in the marsh, anywhere in the country that has redfish, trout, even flounder. I use a lot of these baits for stripers. It looks like a pogie in the water. That's like a pogie color, almost like between a mud minnow and a pogie. And it's got more presence than a lot of the similar, swim baits we use, smaller soft plastics like a gulp or a DOA. Yeah.
And that, you guys can see that on the screen right now if you're watching on the YouTube. That hook is laying flat right against the back right there. And that's what you want so you don't get hung up in those weeds. And, we're throwing in the weeds. That's where the redfish are sitting, especially on that high tide, like you were talking about earlier. If you're not getting in those weeds, your chance of hooking up with one is going down drastically. In order to get in there effectively and save yourself some headache, you got to have that hook right there.
And some good wading shoes, because they're very spooky. It's better to get them on foot if you got soft bottom. Now, I rigged that bait the first time correctly because I've rigged thousands of them. It's going to take you a little while to get used to rigging that bait. It's more difficult than any of the other baits that I've got in front of me now. And a lot of baits of different manufacturers have a rigging channel that you can come through the bottom of it, split the bait, and come out the top, and it's still got a channel in it. These don't have it, but they're very effective. And this hook that I've just picked up has got a keeper on. This is an Eagle Claw 3-0 weighted hook, and it's got a keeper on it out of the box that I don't like using because it doesn't have a center pin. Now, Will has just picked up
I was going to show these guys this
twist lock.
Yeah. And if you guys can see it, it's super small, and I got a Band-Aid on my finger, so excuse me there. But that center pin right there sticks right in the front head of the bait.
It locks it down where you can actually twist it. This bait, this type keeper, hold this one up, Will.
Yeah.
This type keeper, you have really got to put some pressure on it to get it right. I can do it about every time I try it, but it's a lot more time consuming than pressing that pin. That pin actually locks that bait or locks that pin in place where you can actually thread this twist lock into the bait. So I'm going to show you how easy it is to put it on a hook. Actually, Will, you do it. You're closer to the...
I'll see what I can do here. Like I said, my thumb's messed up. We'll see what happens. Yes. I don't know if I can even do it, man.
You do. Here, let me hold it right quick.
Yeah, see if you can do it. I got a Band-Aid on my thumb.
I got one, too. I've been handling so many fish lately. The nearshore bite's been incredible, so I've got them all over me, too. But I don't have one on my tip like you.
Yeah.
Now,
cut my finger on an onion last night.
When you put this thing on the hook, it's very easy, but it's easy to get two of these threads bound up, and it will not go on. Mm-hmm. It will not reach the loop at the end of this twist lock. And that's what these are called. These are called twist lock, and they're medium in size. That's what you want for a bait this size. If you're using a very large bait, even larger than this bait, you will probably want to use the next size up, which is a large twist lock. This is a medium. They make a small. A small I don't use. I don't use baits that small. If I can get the medium in that bait, it's going to hold that bait for a long time, sometimes all day with the right bait.
And the other thing, the way that one threads on the eye of that hook is a little bit different than some of the ones that would come on ones that are on there from
the factory.
From the factory that you're getting in the package with the hooks. Those things, if you can see it, just have like a little clip, like a little hook on the very end of there. And when you're dealing with that, a lot of times those things will pop off on you. So having the one like Rennie just had with the pin on it, you can put it right on there and it just twists right up on it. And you don't have to worry about that you losing that thing when you're on the boat and then having to scramble to find it on the floor or you know, whatever.
There's so many different styles of those twist locks. And that's what Owner calls them. Owner is the one that makes twist locks, which are the pins that we just showed you. Nobody else, to my knowledge, has the twist locks. There might be a small company I don't know about, but all the major companies, including Gamagatsu, which is who makes this hook that I used, which is a perfect size. This is a 3/0 Gamagatsu 16th ounce weighted hook. And what I do is take the keeper off of it and put the twist lock, the Owner twist lock. You can get them at most of your saltwater shops in the Wilmington area. Yeah. There's a lot of them at Bass Pro, the big box stores, Dick's Sporting Goods. If they're not on the shelf, you can ask them to put them on the shelf or order them for you most anywhere. But they're a great little tool to make your life of, you know, putting these soft plastics on these keepers or these hooks so much easier. So I'm going to show you how easy it is. You press that bait up to the twist lock and you just twist it. And you go all the way to the end of the twist lock, almost to the loop, or you can even go over the loop sometimes, depending on where you started it. And this is a Category 5 Manic Minnow. This is one of my favorite baits. It looks just like a little mud minnow. They come in several different colors. And another thing I'm going to tell you is go ahead and bury the point of that hook so you do not get hung in oysters, grass, any kind of structure. You're still going to get hung up in between, like, you know, some kind of V and oyster shells or like a piece of structure or an old root or something from a tree. But if you have that hook tip buried, you have a better chance of not getting hooked. You want to hold that up there?
Yeah, let me show that. That thing is just barely in there, but it's enough to keep it from getting hung up.
When the fish hits it, do not be scared that you're going to miss the fish. Just give it a good hook set.
It's just going to pop right off.
And it's got plenty of gap for that style bait. And that's a big thing is the gap between under the soft plastic to the hook. If it's not a big enough gap, it's just going to push the bait down and you're not going to get a good hook set.
Right.
You got to have enough room between the gap of the hook, this bottom part of the hook, and the bait. So when he hits it, that's enough to fit in a fish's mouth or inside of his mouth. You're going to get a good hook set with that amount of gap. Just the same thing with this Category 5 suicide cracker. You've got plenty of gap right there for that bait to go down, and now it's going to get that fish in the mouth. There's plenty of gap. If it was this hook, there wouldn't be enough gap for this bait to strike on most bites you have. Now, we've talked about the Manic Minnow. They come in a pack like this. They come in several colors. Like I said, it's a smaller profile bait.
Let me hold that one up there.
The action is absolutely incredible. That's what I used yesterday in the river. I was fishing up river with Bo and Eric. So I used that thing pretty much all day. I think I used a couple different colors. The first bait that I fell in love with Category 5 lures after I met with Richie down in Louisiana was the Shrimp Minnow.
Yep.
The action on this bait is absolutely incredible. I rigged it on a 16th ounce bait. My fishing partner was kind of laughing at me. He's like, these are goofy looking baits. And I was like, well, let me put one on a 16th ounce weighted hook and see what happens. So you rig these the same way on the twist locks on a weedless hook. And like I said, I had a 16th ounce weight, which it's hard to get any bait to swim with a 16th of an ounce. Just think about that. Most people that are throwing jig heads are throwing 3/8 or 1/4 ounce jig heads. That's a big jig head. These baits, the action on that tail is absolutely incredible. And that's the Eagle Claw hooks. That's some new hooks that I just got from Eagle Claw. I've been testing them out and had good success. They've got a pretty good size bend down with the point of the hook. And it looks a little goofy when it's rigged sometimes, but they swim incredible. It's got good balance. It's just like the Gamagatsus I'm used to using, like the ones we have in this Manic Minnow. But I tell you what, man, the action on these baits is incredible, and they're different colors. I mean, this is a different green tail than you're going to see on almost any bait. Usually you see chartreuse.
I haven't ever seen one that's that color.
No. And a lot of their baits are like that. Like these, if you'll look at the suicide croakers and the Manic Minnows, they've got some of the weirdest shades of green, blue, orange,
anything you
can think of, and that is enough to trigger a bite sometimes.
Sometimes that's what it takes. We were joking around on one of our last shows about that big gray trout that I got and how bad that jig looked because it didn't have any paint or anything at all on it. But just like that, it might have just been something just slightly different than what they were used to seeing that caused that strike. Same thing with any kind of baits, really, you know, hard baits, soft plastics, something different that they're not used to seeing, because especially on these waters around, you know, Charleston or Wilmington or, you know, anywhere, really, there's a lot of areas that are high-pressured fisheries, and a lot of people are throwing those same exact baits.
That's right.
In every place. Fish are smart. They're going to find it. They're going to notice it.
I had these things to myself in the low country down in South Carolina and Georgia for years fishing tournaments, and then I took a friend of mine, Captain Neil Kendrick, on the boat one day when we were pre-fishing together, and he saw me using those Manic Minnows and the Shrimp Minnows, and he was using Gulp stink bait all day. Mm-hmm. I think the catch ratio at probably middle of the day, I'd caught 10 or 12 fish, and I don't think he had boated one.
Yeah,
he switched over those Manic Minnows. He said, give me some of those baits. I think at first and second cast, he caught fish on the, Category 5. Sometimes, guys.
Just switching it up.
Switching it up and also dropping the scent. I can't stress that enough. Scent educates schools of fish. Yeah. If you're fishing a pressured area, Gulp or any kind of Lunker sauce or any kind of scent could actually work against you instead of for you.
Yeah.
Because those fish have seen it come into school so many times, they know it's not real.
They know something's up.
So,
not saying it doesn't work sometimes
it
works, either. It works sometimes, but there are times when it doesn't work as well.
It's a great search bait in deep water. We do a lot of it, you know, upriver when we're fishing, you know, some of these deep drops from 3 to 50 feet sometimes around structure in the upriver.
Yep.
And it does make a difference sometimes. Yep. But a pressured area, it actually works against you more times than not, I've found over the years.
Good deal.
But anyway.
Well, I love these baits. You know, I've used them quite a bit with you. And, I mean, you're the first one that turned me on to them as well. And, man, they just work. What else can you say?
Absolutely.
They work.
I mean, I use them on my charters. Everybody's been on a charter with me in the last 6 years has seen these baits and how they work.
Yeah, this isn't something new you just started using. You've had these for a long time. You've used them both on your charters and in tournament situations. And, I mean, putting yourself out there like that is, you know, you're not going to put something on there that doesn't work.
No, too much money on the line.
Too much money, yeah.
So, guys, once again, you can get these online through Category 5's website, and I think it's called Category5Outdoors.com. Look on the back of the...
Let's see, yeah, Category 5, as in the number five, Outdoors.com.
Also, at Bass Pro Shops, I think they have a limited selection, and Cabela's, but contact Category 5 Outdoors directly and tell Richie that you heard about the baits on the show.
Yeah, and if your local tackle shop, which we always like to send people to their local mm-hmm. tackle shops to support local businesses, obviously, if they don't have these, hit them up and say, hey, let's get some Category 5s in there. You heard it on the Inshore Journal. Want to give it a try? I know it would be well worth everyone's while to stock these. So.
That's right. And, you know, you guys order them directly, go use them and give us some feedback.
Yeah.
You know, say, you know, Captain Rennie Clark, you were spot on, or Captain Rennie Clark, you're the biggest liar I've ever seen, but I promise you these baits work. And,
absolutely.
You know, that's the thing. If you'll put them in the right situation, I will guarantee you they have got a dynamic action. And I've got a lot of tour guys, man, that are now using these baits, and they're relying on them in tournaments, man. They're not using the scented stuff they've always used, and they're not telling anybody about it, because it's an advantage if you're using something nobody else is using.
This might backfire on you, man.
Yeah.
The secret's out.
The secrets have been out, yeah. So, anyway, guys, thanks for tuning in. Congratulations, Brad Wood. We will be getting that prize pack out to you here soon.
Absolutely. Look for the next one we got coming out. We'll get some more stuff together, and we'll have another contest coming out online, you know, in the near future. Keep your eyes peeled. As always, we really appreciate all those shares out there and all the good comments and messages that we've received. And, yeah, well, thanks a lot for everything.
See you next time.
See you next time. Tight lines.